Peter is, she is just so incredible. Evelia Ariaza lives in Ontario, California, and she's a mother to three active sons who all love football and do not mention anything but the Pittsburgh Steelers when you're talking about the NFL, by the way. She's also the caretaker to both of her mother and her mother-in-law who live with them. She and Dr. Lewis came to Youngevity in 2012 through their company True to Life, and they actually sold their successful chiropractic clinics that were all over LA to focus purely on network marketing. She's always had this entrepreneurial spirit about her from the time that she was a young girl. And she and Lewis have built an incredible team, which has, mic drop here, over 240 five-star executives. And you can only do that with incredible leadership. Her passion is uncovering the greatness in women, and she's been instrumental in helping Michelle Wallach hone the mineral makeup line. She's the sort of friend that will drop everything to be by your side if you need help and support. I've seen her do it. And she and Lewis have received the Presidential Leadership Award in 2016, which is the highest award given in Youngevity. And with that, I want to introduce Evelia Ariaza.
Good morning. Good morning, Denise. I can't see you anymore. Why could I only see myself?
Well, you look good.
Because we all want to see you.
Oh, thank you. Okay, well, thank you so much. I am here in a hotel room, excited to be with all of you. Thank you, Denise, for doing this. Thank you for putting it together. Thank you for having a heart for women, and which is what, like you said, most of our industry is made of. I've had a really good time as I was getting ready listening to Deb. Oh my gosh, I love Deb's energy. She's amazing. And, you know, like Deb said, I love the point that she said, you know, showcase all your stuff, show all your stuff. See, and if you see right behind me, there's some of my Youngevity stuff. And I love what Lisa said about how you have to, what was exactly what she said? Stick with it. You have to stick with it. That is so true. Network marketing. And Lewis and I always call people who bounce from company to company pirates. Like, if you really want to develop success in network marketing, you can't be in one company and another company, even if they're like not conflicting products, right? Like one's a service and one's health related. And let's say like we have everything, right? But you cannot. It's like having two husbands. You just can't do it. And you're never gonna find the level of success that you can have if you really focus. So Denise, you know, I love you for so many reasons. I love you. You are an incredible human being. And I love so much and I respect so much how you have worked on yourself and how you have, you know, you decided that you were going to build the best version of Denise. And that's kind of similar like to myself, right? We're married to two very big, loud men like Lewis and Tom, right? Who sometimes people think that like just by osmosis, we're gonna become great speakers and we're gonna become great presenters and we're gonna do all these amazing things just because they do it. And it doesn't work that way, ladies. We have to do the work too. And for myself, you know, when I came to Youngevity, I had never presented. I've always been the back end of our business. Lewis has always been the front. He always says he's the actor, I'm the director. And so when I came to Youngevity, and I had like Denise mentioned, I love mineral makeup and I have loved it for 20 years. I started using it when I was pregnant with my first son, Fabian, who's almost gonna be 20 now. I know you can't tell, but thanks to Youngevity, I was almost 27 when I had Fabian. And so for me, when I came and I found the best makeup I had ever seen, both in purity and in pigmentation, right? Because we needed to cover, I decided to it was in my heart to tell women that the message of health was not, it was one message that, that our external beauty and our internal beauty are all tied in together. And so that became my passionate message here at Youngevity. There was no message built around that. There was no CEO pack. The makeup paid less, right? Because there was no coding on it. And so I was really going uphill. And I say all of this to encourage you, because some of you may feel like you're always going uphill, but know that if you work on your skills, right? You already have, you came whole. God gave you all the talent, all the ability. You have to unfold that. And here in network marketing, if you work on your skills, you're going to build your confidence, which is what I know so many ladies lack, right? And that's why Denise said, I want you guys to focus on 16 minutes of skill building and 2 minutes of inspiration. So there was my 2 minutes of inspiration to let you know that even though we received all these awards and I consider myself a great presenter and I consider myself very skilled, I've had to work really hard at it. I've had to work really hard and I had to be willing to be bad long enough to get good. So I leave you. So my assignment today is to teach you these 6 points of an invitation, because believe it or not, there is a proper way to invite and an improper way to invite. Whether you're inviting people, right now we can't invite people to large meetings or to group meetings, but we're invite, or it still works whether you're inviting people to a large meeting or to a one-on-one call over the phone or to a Zoom. The steps are always the same. Okay, so I'm gonna give you the steps, then I'm gonna explain the steps a little bit, and then I'm gonna role play at the end. I'm gonna pretend I'm having a conversation with someone, because that always helps me, like, to actually see the steps in action, because then I learn something and I'm like, oh, that sounds so good. Okay, but like, how do I actually talk my way through that? Okay, so step number one is connection. So write these down. A good student is a good note taker. Okay, so number one is connection. Number two is get the why. Okay, number three is emotionalize the why. Number four is edification. Number five is get the appointment. And number six is cement the appointment. Okay, so those are the 6 steps. And I'm gonna start with step number one, connection. Connection in what we do is the utmost important thing above all. You have to be sincere. You have to be present when you're talking to someone. We have to clear our mind of everything that's going on in our lives, in our heads, if we really want to be effective with that person. So number one is connection. Okay. And sometimes when, especially in Youngevity, because we have so many things, like we tend to throw, some people like tend to throw up on people. And you offer them everything we have, and then they're just thoroughly confused and people don't buy. Okay. So you have to be really intentional. And in connection, you have to give, write this down. You have to give people what they need, not what you have. Okay, Youngevity, we don't tell people about everything we have. We give people what they need. It is super important to give people what they need because, you know, I'm a builder. I'm a big recruiter. I'm a big builder. Like Lisa said, I like to spend money. I'm more than liking to spend money. I like to make my money grow, which means I have to save money. And to make my money grow, I have to make a lot of money to have extra to make it grow. So I'm a builder, and we have to be very specific about how we help people, because not if I'm meeting with somebody who is sick, for example, I'm not going to tell her how Youngevity helped us recover 8 years ago from a bankruptcy, how we've made millions of dollars here at Youngevity. I'm not going to tell her that because she's sick. So I have to give her what she needs. Same thing, if there's someone who lost their job and needs to make money, I'm not going to tell her about the 100 and something ingredients in BTT or how the liver, or the detox will clear out her liver. I'm not gonna tell her any of that because it's not pertinent to her case. So when you're with somebody, that's the way you connect, by giving them, that person, what that person needs. And remember also to speak less and listen more. Okay, that's an important part of connection too. Sometimes as network marketers, and we're so excited, we wanna tell them how great Youngevity is, and we get an opportunity to actually connect with someone and we blow it. By talking about what they don't need, and by telling them about everything we have, and about just talking. So make sure that you're listening. Okay, so step number two, get the why. We all talk about the why, right? Network marketing, that's old news for us. We've been talking about the why since 50 years ago, right? Now, Simon Sinek made it really popular lately in corporate America. So now everybody's talking about getting the why. And we all know that getting the why is super important because that's the essence of how you're going to move someone. Initially, you know, and I'm a strong believer that you can't get somebody's why in the first time you meet them or in the first conversation. You kind of just get a scenario of their why, but not, it's so much bigger. Like when people says, I need to make more money. Well, that's not really your why, right? Or I need more health. But that's not really your why. It's so much deeper than that. There's reasons of like, I don't want to, oops, that was a phone call. Let's see. Okay. I don't want to be a failure, or, you know, back to like, oh, you know, my dad told me I could never do this or whatever. But initially getting the why, understanding what's important to that person is super imperative. Okay, then third, you're going to emotionalize the why. So you want to emotionalize the why because as human beings, we cannot think and emote simultaneously. So when you're talking to someone, you have to make that why emotional, kind of dig in a little bit, you know, that cup, put a little bit of lemon on it. And trust me, when I first heard this concept, I thought, gosh, that sounds mean, right? Or like manipulative. No, it's not. Because some people are so beat up that they've lost the hope. Like that's the number one thing. Like I always tell people, what are you doing in longevity? I give people hope because people have lost hope. They don't believe in themselves. They believed all the lies. And so sometimes we have to kind of help, we have to emotionalize the why so they get out of their head, because in our heads is where we have all these limitations for ourselves. And so emotionalizing the why is so important because you're going to get that person to open up genuinely, to be a little more receptive to you. Okay. So then after you emotionalize the why, your fourth step is edification. Edification is extremely important. It's the most powerful tool you will have in network marketing. And edification is a whole series of training on its own, maybe another day. And so you edify your upline, because if you're new, or even if you've had success, a lot of success here in longevity, I'm always edifying people. I'm always edifying Denise. Oh my gosh, you know, I'm always edifying Tom. I'm always edifying even someone on my team, Carmen, Martha, whoever it may be. I'm always edifying someone because it takes the attention off of yourself. And for example, like I have, thank goodness, never had a major illness. I've never had to battle with any disease. And so if someone's battling a disease, how am I going to really connect with them? Well, I'm going to use someone else with my testimony, edify somebody else who has a similar experience. Okay. So after you edify, and you're gonna see how all of this works. Okay, now an edification is super important because in inviting, you're like, okay, so why is this important in inviting? It's so important because it's going to reduce the amount of cancellations you'll have. Because when you are edifying someone, Now this person knows that they're going to meet her, right? So Denise, I edified Denise, and Cynthia knows she's going to come with me to meet Denise. And I just told her how great Denise is. And she's going to feel really bad canceling on me, because now she's not just canceling on me, but she's also canceling on Denise. Okay. Step number five is you set the appointment. So when you're talking to someone, and this is a conversation for all of you, this, okay, through text, I know texts are popular, but you're not going to connect and you're not going to get someone's why over a text. So when you set the appointment, as human beings, we like to think that we're in control and we don't like being told what to do. That's just psychology 101. Okay. And so what we do is when you're going to set an appointment, you tell Denise, okay, Denise, so you already spoke to your upline and you already know, right, that Tom is available Sunday at 10 and Monday at 6. So you're like, okay, Denise, so what works better for you, morning or afternoon? You have a morning and afternoon slot already for Tom. And then Denise is going to say, oh, okay, mornings. Okay, great. So what day is better for you, Sunday or Monday? And then God willing, she's going to say Sunday, right? And so then, and you're like, okay, perfect. So what you did there is you kind of let her, you gave her options and you let her to set an appointment on the days that were convenient for your upline. But she's thinking that she set the appointment because you gave her choices. Okay, so that's really important. It's really important to allow people to think that they're making the decision. And you may think this isn't a big deal, but in the way our mind works as human beings, it's a very, very big deal. And people will stick to the appointment more if we follow the steps. Now, step number six, cement the appointment. So once you have the appointment, I'm going to tell Denise, Denise, you know, I'm so happy that you're going to talk to Tom at 10 o'clock on Saturday. And, you know, Tom has helped me so much. He's helped me grow my business, but more importantly, he's helped me have time to spend with my children. He's helped me have time to take care of my mothers, which is so important to me. And so, you know, Tom, I know you don't know Tom yet. I've told you a little bit about Tom, but it's so important to me that you please, like, don't pencil it in, put it in ink that Sunday at 10 o'clock, we're going to speak with Tom, because Tom has really helped me. And I don't want to lose my credibility with Tom. I don't want to look bad in front of Tom, because he's taking this time. He could be talking to 100 other people and he made the time to talk to us. So can you promise me that you're going to be there Saturday at 10 a.m. on that phone call? And so then Denise is going to be like, yeah, okay, I'm going to be there. Because see, again, she's going to feel a little bad about canceling, because now she's not just canceling on you, but she's making you look bad in front of somebody who you respect and admire. Right. Okay, so I have 2 minutes left, Louis said. Okay, so the role play. For example, I am married. I have an amazing husband that I build this business with. I have my kids. I have my mothers. I have all these things going on, right? So I'm going to be talking to a woman who's a single mother, right? Let's just say Jane. Jane is a single mother. She has two kids. And Jane has always told me how I've been inviting her to meetings, but she doesn't come. And so this is my phone call with Jane, okay? And you're going to see me walk through all the steps in my conversation with Jane, okay? So Jane, I'm going to make sure you're on that Zoom at 7 o'clock. Oh, you know what, Avelia, I'm so busy. You know, I told you, like, I get home at 6, I feed the kids, I could barely look at their homework, and now with homeschooling, like, it's just a hot mess, and then I have to put them to bed. Like, I don't think I could be there. Miss Jane, but you've been telling me this for 3 months. I've been asking you to talk to my friend for 10 months. I've been asking you to talk to my mentor for 10 months. And you've been telling me that you have no time to see your children. You've been telling me how you're so overwhelmed. You've been telling me how you hate that you just put them to bed and wake them up and that you're not involved in their lives. But you're telling me you don't have 20 minutes of your day to talk to somebody who could help you get out of that situation. Jane, when is this ever going to change? When is this ever going to change? It's been 3 months. And before, since you've been telling me, because it's been the last 5 years since you've been a single mom that you've been doing this, when is it going to change? I tell you, the most rewarding thing for me about what I do is that I don't miss a second of my children's lives. Any of them, my son, who's almost going to be 20, the connection and the things that I get to do with him, my younger sons, and I'm a team mom and I'm active in every single element of their lives. I wouldn't trade that for the world. And so Jane, please just take a few minutes. I promise you that this has the possibility to change your life. So as you see there, what I did is I didn't talk to Jane about how, oh, I built this business with my husband and I do this with my husband. Like right now, he's literally right here, like 2 feet away from me. And I don't talk to her about how much the millions of dollars I've made, because that's not relevant to Jane. I emotionalized her why. I cemented the appointment in a way that is truthful to Jane. So back to step number one, connection is I gave Jane what she needed and not what I had to offer. So I think my time is up and we could have done a whole hour training on this. I hope it was understandable in 18 minutes. And Denise, thank you so much for inviting me and for doing this for all of us here at Ingevity.
Avelia, thank you. And you're right. I mean, here's the thing, you guys, if you don't know how to invite, then you can't build a business, because that is one of the most fundamental skills that we all must learn. And I love that Avelia has broke it down into 6 simple steps. And for me, the role play is that's how things get cemented into me, is through role playing. Like I can, you know, conceptualize it, but when I actually hear it, it makes such a huge difference. So, oh geez, look who's here. Hello.
Behind every great woman, is a good man.
It's a peeping Tom. No, I'm kidding.
I have a peeping Lewis over here, but he's not decent.
I heard Lewis's voice. You know, and that's the thing about you, Avelia is in a hotel room because they're going to a
Chihuahua.
They're in Chihuahua, and they're going to a wedding. And the one of the qualities of a true leader is being flexible.
So this has been a great training, you guys. I'm going to get out of here. I've got it in my other ear, so I just heard the reverb of me listening to me. But I am telling you, Deb Hall and Lisa Nelson and now Avelia, I can't wait to listen to the rest.
Yeah.
And guess where I'm going, everyone, to get my hearing aids now. Woohoo!
Oh, wow.
No more selective hearing. Uh-oh.